Chapter 2. When Arthur got back to the classroom, his friends rushed to his side. "You survived," said Buster. "We know of your signs of torture," Binky added. He looked a little disappointed. "What happened?" asked Francie. Arthur let out a sigh. "Mr. Henry gave me this." He held up a large brown envelope. "He said it was for my mom." "That's it?" asked Muffy. She reached out for a closer look. "What does it say? Is it sealed?" Francie grabbed the envelope. "It's sealed, all right." She held up to the light. And too thick to read through. "Give it a shake," said Buster, cocking his ears. Francie shook the envelope for a moment. It rustled softly. "That doesn't tell us much," she said. Binky formed his arms. "Let's just open it." "I can't," said Arthur. "It's addressed to my mother and was stamped on it. Private and confidential." "That's a bad sign," said Buster. "Good news is never private." "Besides," said Binky, "you can't start making excuses until you know what kind of trouble you're in." "Didn't Mr. Henry give you any clues at all?" Francine asked. "He said it was important," said Arthur, taking back the envelope. That was about it." "If it was a good news," said Muffy, "Mr. Henry would have told you. My mother always tells me right away if we gotten a new limousine or if the cook is making a special dessert for dinner." "She didn't say anything like that," Arthur admitted. "That means it's bad news," says Francine. "The question is, how bad is it?" This was a not question Arthur wanted to think about. Binky laughed. "Oh, I bet you lost a library book. I don't think Mr. Henry gets involved with overdue library books," said Arthur. "Besides, I just returned her mine." "Oh no," said Francie. "What?" said Muffy. "Tell us," said Buster. "Tell me," said Arthur. "Never mind," said Francie. "It's too terrible to think about." Arthur turned pale. "That's why you have to tell me." "All right," said Francie. "But you forced me into it," she shuddered. "But why? What if you didn't pass Mr. Redburn's history test?" Arthur frowned. The big test had been the week before. It had been a hard one. "Remember, Arthur, you told me afterward that you wrote how the Pilgrim came to America in 1620. Francie, the Pilgrim did come to America in 1620. She looked surprised. "Really?" Everyone else nodded. "Well, still," Francie tapped the envelope. "The proof is right here. And if you fail the test, you might fail the whole year. You know what that means? Summer school." Arthur sat down in his chair and thought about his fate. Summer school, perhaps the two most dreaded words in the English language. He saw himself chained to the work of the dark dungeon. Outside the bar window, he could hear his friends playing. He looked out through the bars. Buster and the Brain were setting up a tent for camping. Muffy and Prunella were all upbraiding. Arthur looked around his cell. He was alone, with only some thick, dusty books for company. Then the guard, Mr. Redbrand, walked in. He was sweeping ice cream from a cone. A few drops fell on the stone, just behind Arthur's reach. "Snap out of it, Arthur," said Buster. Arthur looked at his friends blankly. "You know what they say," said Buster, went on. "Those who don't learn their history are doomed to repeat it." Arthur sighed. History or not, he felt doomed for sure.